We had a meeting between the EPP group and Mr. Orban. I understand that there were some critical comments. There were many who applauded Mr. Orban. But at the end of the day, you have to take a decision. Are you on the Commission side? Are you on the side of our Vice President, Mrs. Reding? Or are you on the side of Mr. Orban in what he's doing, in violating rules? You know, are you on the side of the rule of law or not? You have to decide. And I turn to Council. I would like to ask Council to please adopt a clear stance. What we heard this morning was not clear. Do you or do you not support the Commission concerning its activities in this area? You know, we've had some debates. We've talked about Romania in the past. The situation, of course, there is completely different. But what about today? Today, what this debate is all about, and I said this already in the past, I support the Commission, and today what we have to say is whether or not we give confidence to the Commissioner, that the Commissioner has to act in order to stop a violation of the law. And I don't think that the European People's Party can simply turn a blind eye to that or avoid the whole debate. We, as Social Democrats, certainly support the Commission. A final comment, if I may. Onat Laudet, on behalf of the Jewish community in the United States of America, has come up with some words which were very critical. And I don't want to, you know, make this person responsible, the person in Hungary responsible for the rise of anti-Semitism, but I'm talking to the EPP. What's happening in Hungary? For instance, you have professors at the university, you've got, you know, their names on the doors of their offices, and now people are putting graffiti on that saying Jewish. That is not acceptable. That is not acceptable neither for Mr. Orban nor for the Fidesz party. This anti-Semitism has to end. It must end. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Svoboda. As I said at the start, I'm very sorry, but as I said at the start of this debate, we agreed that there is to be no blue card procedure or catch the eye procedure during it. I explicitly stated it. It's nothing to do with democracy. It's simply a question of the rules. And it's been determined by the political groups. I am going to abide by a decision that you, the political groups, have taken. Well, if you absolutely must speak, then okay, ask your stupid question. Obviously, if, you know, the president sweeps the rules aside, it's fine if it's your case.
Meg kell most kérdezni, hogy Svoboda frakcióvezető beleegyezik-e ahhoz, hogy én kérdést tegyek fel neki, de úgy látom, hogy ez így van. Szeretném megkérdezni Svoboda urat, hogy tudja-e azt ön, hogy tegnap a Magyar Bíróság az új alaptörvénynek a negyedik módosítása alapján tiltotta be azt az agygázt nevezetű antiszemita motoros tüntetést, amely a holokauszt emléknapon, amelyet az Orbán kormány vezetett be, az élet menete ellen kívánt egy szélső jobboldali csoport elindítani. Tud-e ön erről? Még egy kérdést, hogyha föltehetek, akkor hadd tegyem föl azt is, hogy ön bírálta azt, hogy a Magyarországon az alkotmányt módosították az Alkotmánybíróság döntése alapján. Az ön által, az ön pártja által vezetett koalíció Bécsben nemrégiben egy taxisrendelet kapcsán a nagy koalíció keretében módosította az alkotmányt, mert nem tetszett neki az Alkotmánybíróságnak egy döntése. Ön nem ugyanazt kritizálja-e Magyarországon, mint amit önök Ausztriában maguk is csinálnak? Köszönöm.
Thank you. Well, on your second question, it's the Austrian Parliament. And it was 30 years ago, Mr. Sire, not the government, it was the parliament, and it was greatly criticised by myself and many other colleagues. You should really get better information. Secondly, it's difficult to follow, you know, because there's decisions being taken all the time here. I take due note of what you say. But it is very important that there should be pressure from Europe and the Hungarian government, and that is exactly what shows it. Now, let me ask you one more thing. You put a stop to all this anger against Miss Reding in Hungary. She's being called the Commission's pit bull in Hungary. And for me, as a politician on the opposite side of the House, that is still an unacceptable stirring up of feeling against Miss Reding to describe a Vice President of the Commission as the pit bull of Europe.
So the Cohn Bendit has.
Mr. Cohn Bendit has asked to speak on a point of order.
Well, I think this is dreadful. At the Conference of Presidents, Mr. Sayer was present at that meeting. A decision was taken that no questions be put. So in that case, there's no point meeting anymore. We don't need to have any kind of agreements and strike them with you, sir. You were present at that meeting. It doesn't really matter whether you're there or not. This is impossible. And that's on the rules of procedure.
So, okay.
My dear colleagues, perhaps we could try to be a little calmer. This is an emotional debate. You know, let's not beat about the bush. You know, you can clearly see that it's a clear split here on this issue. That's the political situation. So from up here, really what you've got to do is try and channel your emotions.